In this video, I am going to explain core muscles around pelvis. It's on basically the inferior part of pelvis. And today's muscles are classified as core muscles, but this is in broad sense. In narrow sense, these guys are not core muscles, but today's muscles are so important for core stability, urination, and ejaculation, and other kind of sexual activity. Okay? So, first part, I want to talk about three muscles. First one is this one, this kind of a ring-shaped muscle. This is puborectalis. Puborectalis, because this muscle is close to pubis and rectum. Imagine rectum is right here. Okay, puborectalis. Next one is this one. This is pubococcygeus. Pubococcygeus, because it's connect to pubis and coccyx. Makes sense. And last one is this one. This is iliococcygeus. Iliococcygeus, because it's from ilium, then it goes to coccyx. Makes sense. And all these three muscles together, this is called levator ani. Levator ani, okay? And this is also called as pelvic diaphragm. Diaphragm. You know, if you think about diaphragm, you may think about, you know, breathing diaphragm, okay? But diaphragm means kind of a horizontal structure in body. And these guys, these muscles are thin, and its orientation is pretty much horizon. That is why these muscles can be called as pelvic diaphragm, or this can be called as pelvic floor. Yes, these guys are so important for urination and sexual function. Very important. Puborectalis, pubococcygeus, and iliococcygeus. And I want to go to a little bit more detail about this kind of muscles. Okay, this is inferior view. First picture was superior view. This is superior view, and this is inferior view. I was talking about pelvic diaphragm. Now I want to talk about urogenital diaphragm. Urogenital diaphragm. I want to talk about two muscles. First one is this one, this broad one. This is broad, but this is very, very thin. This is deep transverse perineum. Deep transverse perineum, which is this thin membrane kind of muscle. If there's deep transverse perineum, there should be shallow part, okay? This one is superficial transverse perineum. Superficial transverse perineum. This yellow one. Okay? These two muscles are called as urogenital diaphragm. You can suggest their function. Yep, they are related to urinary system and genital system. Okay, then I want to talk about sphincters and other muscles. First one is this one. This muscle is kind of a circular shape muscle around anus. Thus, this is external anal sphincter. External anal sphincter. What is sphincter? Sphincter is like a ring-shaped kind of muscle then that constricts, then that brings thing outside. Okay, that makes sense. External anal sphincter. Then, if there's anal sphincter, there should be urethral sphincter. That is this part, this tiny one. This is external urethral sphincter. External urethral sphincter. By the way, this is female pelvis. Thus, external urethral sphincter of male shapes differently. You know, this is a difference between male and female. Anyway, this is external anal sphincter. This is external urethral sphincter. I want to talk about two more muscles. This one is close to ischium. Okay, this is ischium. This thin muscle is called ischiocavernosus. Ischiocavernosus. And last muscle, which you don't see in this picture, is like this circular muscle. This is bulbospongiosus. Bulbospongiosus. These muscles are important for digestive system and urogenital function. Their names are kind of confusing at first time, but as I said, today's muscles are so important for digestive system and urogenital function. Then I wanna add few more muscles. Okay, I came back to first picture. First muscle I wanna talk about for extra is this one. This is coccygeus. Coccygeus. This is not classified as pelvic floor, but since this muscle attaches to coccyx and pelvis, I believe function of this muscle has important role for pelvic floor because they are literally close each other. Okay, does it make sense? It's close to iliococcygeus, right? Then next one is this one, this yellow one. This is obturator internus. Obturator internus. This is a hip muscle. This is part of deep lateral rotator. Deep lateral rotator. But how come this is related to pelvic floor? There is interesting thing. Do you remember this muscle? This is iliococcygeus. Iliococcygeus actually attaches to fascia of obturator internus. Okay? Iliococcygeus attaches to fascia of obturator internus. Thus, when obturator internus or iliococcygeus gets tight, that can affect each other, right? Does it make sense? That's why obturator internus is part of hip muscle. However, if you think about this connection, maybe obturator internus can affect pelvic floor. This is very, very important. Last extra muscle is this one. This is piriformis. Piriformis. This is also part of deep lateral rotator. If you look its origin is here. It's anterior part of sacrum. Anterior part of sacrum. Why is that so important? Because there are many organs, many deep muscles such as pelvic floor in front of sacrum. Okay? Many organs and many deep muscles are in front of sacrum. Then, again, piriformis originates from anterior part of sacrum. What happens if piriformis gets tight? That tightness can affect pelvic floor. Or, tightness of pelvic floor may affect piriformis. It's like a same relationship of obturator internus and pelvic floor. That is why these muscles, coccygeus, obturator internus, and piriformis can be classified as part of pelvic floor. This is not on a textbook of anatomy, but this is my opinion. These muscles are important for pelvic floor function and relationship. If you liked today's video, please hit the like button, comment, and subscribe. See you next video.